Stunning revelations tonight about the well-being of five children living in filth in Liberty. They had been under state supervision for years, but never out of the care of their parents, who are now charged with neglect. KMBC9's Peggy Bright is live in Liberty. Peggy.
Larry, this is the townhome that they lived in for some 2 years. Take a look at the front door tonight, and you can see that it has now been condemned for its deplorable conditions. But long before now, for years in fact, the kids had come to the attention of Children's Services. Tonight, their grandfather says he has one concern.
Basically, it's the welfare of the children. I mean, I love my grandkids. I don't want them to be hurt. I love them.
Scott Stein is heartbroken over how the kids were found 2 days ago when police were called here on a report that 27-year-old Paul Jenkins was threatening the lives of his children. 27-year-old Bethany Jenkins arrived home a few minutes later and was arrested. That's because police had already found the kids inside. The youngest were covered in feces and urine, as were the bedrooms. The oldest kid's school was concerned enough that they had made several hotline calls over time. Relatives and neighbors said they did too.
My girlfriend has called. My girlfriend's best friend lives here. She's called several times. The next door neighbor has called several times. Everybody is called.
Children's Services say they can't talk about a specific case, but in general, they say every hotline call is investigated. They also say they can't remove children from a home. Police have to do it, or a judge has to order it. Bethany Jenkins' mother and stepdad say they won't defend the conditions at the home. They just want the kids to get the kind of care they need.
I'm not taking any sides except the children's side. They are totally innocent of anything, and they need to be kept that way.
Now, it doesn't look as if anybody is going to be moving back into this townhome anytime soon. Both Paul and Bethany Jenkins made their first court appearances this afternoon and then asked for public defenders. They remain in jail. His bond set at $200,000, hers at $100,000.